As Luxembourg's Minister of Energy, which energy sources should be prioritized for the future of Luxembourg and the world?
So the first fuel, the most important energy, is energy efficiency. So new houses in Luxembourg have very stringent standards so that we reduce already the total energy demand. And of course, taking an electric bike or an electric bus is always more efficient than an electric car, although the electric car is more efficient than a diesel car. So energy efficiency is very, very important. There's no way to get to our climate change agenda if we don't prioritize energy efficiency. And then, of course, the rest is about renewables. In Luxembourg, that is solar energy, wind onshore, that will be a bit of geothermal, and some sustainable biomass that will bring us to roughly 40-45% of electricity and also roughly energy in Luxembourg. And the rest, for a small country in the center of Western Europe, will be imports. And we are now strengthening our power lines to Germany. Germany is our reference market, also because Germany goes very fast renewable, so 80% of German electricity will be renewables in 2030. And we do also cooperation agreements with Denmark on one hand to get their electricity from offshore winds to Luxembourg or the Baltic states.
And how does Luxembourg approach energy security and diversification of energy sources? And what strategies can be pursued to ensure a stable and sustainable energy supply for the country?
We try to be a front runner on everything which is intelligence in the grid. So I give you one example. We give support, financial support for charging of electric cars, but we link it to the intelligence of the charging stations. And we are now almost finalized on a national energy data platform where we will use the data from the smart meters in Luxembourg. We have a 99% rollout of smart meters, and we do as much IT in the energy system as possible. And that allows us flexibility, plus then, of course, being in the middle of the Western European electricity power market and with very strong links, especially to the German power market. That's our energy security strategy.
And what are some of the key challenges and opportunities in transitioning to a more sustainable and renewable energy future?
So I think it's, of course, putting into practice and on the ground energy efficiency measures, rolling out renewables, rolling out flexibility and intelligence. And for that, one is technology. All technology is there. In Luxembourg, we don't have a problem of financing the energy transition. So our biggest challenge is the social fabric. And the social fabric about, do we have enough skilled craftsmen to mount all the solar panels, to mount all the heat pumps, to do the retrofit of existing buildings? And the second is, we try to be as inclusive as possible in our energy policy. So we try not to lose any citizen in that transition. And for example, we pay 100% of all energy transition of the low income. So a low-income person in Luxembourg will get 100% refit of a heat pump. We are trying also to organize pre-financing of this kind of retrofit or energy transition. And we do also organizational, let's say, help for those parts of population which have lower income. So it's about lifelong learning for the whole sector, attracting young people, the Fridays for Future Generation. So on Fridays on the streets and from Monday to Friday morning on the roof to build up the solar panels. So that's our strategy, and then be inclusive.